Hello everyone, this is Daemonikin, and I'm still feeling kinda sick, but not bad enough to the point where I can't do a Let's Play or something. Anyway, I decided to play a Mario fan game instead of a Mario hack, and here we are, Super Mario Pearls of Wisdom by TheMegajord of YouTube, also known as Firestyle on Yo-Yo Games. Yeah, this is a Game Maker game. And I decided to give this one a shot because, other than his own little sort of walkthrough through the game, I'm assuming it's a him, I haven't really seen anyone else do this. So, without further ado, here we go. Oh, come on, I set the controls. Okay, now everything seems to be working. I guess I didn't click the window or something stupid. Anyway, so we'll go ahead and click on New Game. And the controls are a bit wonky. As you can see, Mario moves pretty quick in any one direction if you hold it. Let's talk to our bro. Hey bro, finally woke up, huh? Remember Peach and Daisy invited us to go on a cruise for the summer? Did she now? They're waiting at the pier, huh? And he can jump fairly high for a normal jump and all. That's pretty nice, I suppose. The block hitting works well enough. Gonna have to jump to go forward, of course. Well, this is Mario. If we didn't have to jump to go forward, this wouldn't be quite a Mario fan game now, would it? Unless it had a completely different playstyle from platforming. Anyway. Darn it, bro, these blocks are blocking our path. Press down in the air to do a ground pound. You can also jump while holding up to do a spin jump. So we can do that. Or this, which is a lot more awkward since the ceiling is a boundary for Mario 2 in this thing. So let's just move forward. Look, it's some Goombas! They'll damage you if you touch them. Jump on them to defeat them. Yeah, the bars in the upper left corner aren't there for decoration. That's actually your health. When you take a hit, you take one... Well, you take one hit. Eat a mushroom, you heal. Fairly simple enough. Right. And we can also pick up things with the same X button. Oh, what is that guy? He looked like Tatanga or something. Press down to duck, press Z while ducking, do a backflip. Well, I did the wrong thing. I'm supposed to sit still and duck. And then you can do a high jump. Just like that. Yeah. Lots and lots of Tatanga-type aliens. And cutscene time, because, well, fan games gotta have a plot. Peach Daisy, what's happening? And also Mario can't talk again.
I don't know, we were just waiting for you guys when all this happened. Bunch of aliens just randomly came and started destroying the place. They look familiar, though.
Kinda hope so.
Well then, why are we still standing here? Let's get on your ship and get out of here!
Leaving so soon?
Really, that's him? Okay. He's a bit shorter than I thought he might have been, but oh well. Several years, you mean like 20 or so? Yeah, Peach, you go ahead and order him to stop his invasion. As if, like you stopped all of Bowser's, right? Oh, wait. Amulet of Krat? Okay, now we're just making stuff up. Then again, Paper Mario went ahead and had the Star Rod. Well, we were planning on running away anyway, so what the heck? Yeah, we got kicked out of our own kingdom. Well, you usually get kidnapped instead. That's a bit different. E.T. Apparently Steven Spielberg movies exist in the Mushroom Kingdom. Because otherwise, Daisy wouldn't have known about E.T. And now we have, well, the title drop, The Pearls of Wisdom. Water, fire, earth, wind, thunder, and shadow. I wonder why it's a video game trope to accidentally replace thunder with lightning. Or, actually, it's the other way around. Why people mistake lightning for thunder because they're two totally completely different things. I mean, seriously. One is a huge shockwave and the other... One's a huge shockwave of sound and the other is, well... electricity. And yes, we could actually board the ship. And there's also save blocks here. You hit them from underneath and you can save your game. However, I'm gonna say no for now, just in case this recording goes sour. Welcome to my fabulous personal lotion liner. Shop for items, play mini games, and talk to people. They don't really have much importance to say, do they? When you get a power-up, you can use its abilities with the X button. All except the cloud power-up, which lets you jump 3 times and float with X. Well, that's an X button option, isn't it? Just talk to Luigi if we want to go. So now if we're backtracking through older levels for coin grinding or something. Can't jump on every enemy, you see? Use your judgment. I'll move my mouse out of the way. Yeah, you gotta use the high jump to get up here. Funny that. Whee! Okay, enough fooling around. Let's go down here. The general store. Let's see what's here. Fire flower. I do believe that's a nice flower. Cloud flower. Bee shroom. Volt shroom. Boulder shroom. Hammer suit. Boomerang suit. Full health recovery. And a big ol' Yoshi egg. Not that you'd be able to see it through the, entirely through the, the big ol', price tag. Swim with a Z button. Coops, there you are. What are you doing here? Depending on where the ship's docked, different people will show. Hello, Cooper. Well, this is slightly awkward. Both of my party members from the games, and I'm not gonna bother talking to people because it's kind of time-wasty. Okay, the practice planes. And yes, this game has MIDI music all over the place, so get used to it. It's not that it even sounds all that bad. Well, I could have gotten hit by that Koopa reading that. Okay, so basically you can store your power-ups in case you don't want to lose them when you take a whack by pressing space. So there it is sitting in one of my 3 item boxes. And you activate them by pushing the corresponding number key up there, so that's a 1. That's in the first slot, so I push 1. And I have my fire out. Simple as can be. Use the arrow keys to enter pipes. And here I am with the cloud flower. When you duck, you're invisible for some reason. For a little bit. You can do a triple jumpy thing and float down gently with your hat. That's actually pretty clever because I don't think Mario did that in Galaxy with his hat. Okay, and then the bee shroom because we don't have quite enough of these Galaxy power-ups yet. Okay, so basically it makes our ground pound all bouncy like that so we can just totally squash everything in our path. X makes you do this when you're on the ground, the butt slammy thing sideways. Oh yeah, that's right, you can't ground pound those. Durr. Okay. Volt shroom lets you throw electricity straight forward, but you can only shoot 1. And vegetables. Gotta kill all the Goombas using, well, Luigi's powers, let's face it. Oh, good thing I wasn't standing close enough to that bomb to take a whack. Yeah, the thing about bombs is that if they take a hit and die, Yoshi? Yes, I am riding Yoshi, and he's got the flutter jumpy thing. can eat enemies. They don't turn into coins, though. Okay, so I can do the whole Yoshi ditch thing. Not that I'm gonna use this often, because, like other games, Yoshi counts as a free hit. Then we beat the level, nothing special for clearing it or anything. In a special manner, like hitting the tip or anything silly like that. Okay then, now I'll do one more level, Lakeside Jug, to end this off. Okay, out of my way, Goomba. Health! And let's go swimming for a bit. Why? There's grass underwater, too. I'm not curious enough to get off of Yoshi to figure it out, though. Okay, so Yoshi can't lick power-ups. I've had a bit of a trouble with those mouse guys in that they really don't want you to stomp on them, even though that's one way to kill them. I don't know what it is, but with the... with some of these games, but it's like, if the enemy is rising and you're falling, like, somehow the collision detection goes through your jumping hitbox, or some nonsense. I'm not gonna bother picking that up because I already have one in reserve. Once again, I already have one in reserve, so I'm not gonna bother. Okay, these Hammer Brothers are a touch cheap. Main reason is that their hammers will home down on you. And you can't kill the Hammer Brothers by hitting their blocks from underneath or anything. So, you gotta be really careful with those ones. The bomb's about to blow. There we go. Yeah, sometimes there's actually mushrooms down here too, so it's worth picking up stuff every now and again. Not always, obviously, because, you might just get vegetables or coins instead, and those aren't worth too much. Yay! That were close. Oi. Duck ball running to slide. Jump ball sliding to perform a long jump. Yeah, but I can jump about as far this way. Or I can totally drown myself! That water's a touch deep, I suppose. Further down. Or maybe there's a boss bass down there. I wouldn't doubt that. Okay, then. So let's quit fooling around with these pits and actually jump them, huh? Okay, then. So, wow. File size is really small, so I'll go ahead and do Rocky Mountains and then seriously finish this video for now. Hi, Bullet Bill Cannon. How are you? Whoa! Ah, jeez, we're pretty trigger happy right now, aren't we? Jeez, hello. Yeah, the cannons in this game are a touch quick to fire their bills. Yay! Case in point, I just bounced off of one. Right when the cannon spawned. No, Mario, I wanted to do this jump. Games. Fan games. They all have their little quirks. Oh, that was a bomb Koopa? Okay. Mine! So yeah, now I can throw hammers. And they arc. Like the axes in Castlevania, and then I kill my power-up. Hooray! I really do love wasting powers like that, and I do also love taking unnecessary hits. That's also a bonus. Okay, the wall jumping's a bit odd too, especially since I keep wanting to do the ground pound instead. I don't know. It just kind of seems low, but I guess Firestyle thought this ahead because you can't jump any higher off of a single wall than you can. Case in point. Should have waited for the piranha. Oh well. Yay! Good thing I'm not hunting red coins or anything. Yeah, don't ground pound to go any faster there. That's usually a bad idea. Okay then, so... There's really not much to say about these levels, I suppose. Except the background moves up and down with you. And, well, this has been the start of something different. I plan to do more of these kinds of things somewhere along the line when I feel I'm running dry with the hacks. So, anyway, this has been some Super Mario and the Pearls of Wisdom. And perhaps you'll join me next time, perhaps not.